Hello students, my name is Shayan Mitra. I am the faculty member of Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering of Greater Kolkata College of Engineering and Management. Today I am going to take the class of Advanced Communication Engineering, and this is the first lecture that I am going to conduct. And as you know, the screen is showing that the subject code is ETC ACE6. Okay. So as you are saying that today is the introductory class. So in this first lecture, I'm going to give you a brief description about the syllabus I'm going to cover in this specific semester, in this event semester. The syllabus I'm going to cover in this semester is for this subject. Regarding this subject is satellite communication. Next, we're going to cover the module 2, which is about the optical communication, where we are going to discuss about the optical fiber, the use of optical fiber, the working principle of optical fiber, and we will have a deep discussion, deep analysis of optical fiber. Okay. The third, we are going to discuss about the mobile networks, and with mobile networks we are going to have some, we have few examples of mobile telephone, different kind of devices which are being used in mobile telephony. Okay. And next, the last, probably the mobile telephone is the last module that I'm going to cover, because that will only cover a few devices regarding the mobile telephone, such as the mobiles, more devices. And the last, the second last module that I'm going to cover in this subject is PN's communication, PN sequence communication. Okay, that's also interesting. In this lecture, today's lecture, as an introductory lecture class or video lecture, I would say, we in this today's lecture we're going to cover few topic about the mobile networks. Today I'm going to start with mobile networks. We will complete mobile networks. As soon as we complete the mobile networks part, it is a I'm taking the class accordingly with cordially with the lectures that I'm going to upload. Okay, so it will take, I think, according to our syllabus module, it will take 6 to 7 hours. So probably I have to have 7 to 8 lecture to cover the mobile network part, and according to that, probably I will the surplus videos, probably it will take, as it is a 15 minute video, so it will take few more videos, probably it will take 10 or 12 videos, probably depending upon the schedule of the class. Yes, so yes, I think 4 video per, so it's 4 to 10 to 15 videos will be enough to cover. 10 videos will be more than enough to cover the mobile network part. So I will upload the videos according to the demand. Okay, according to the requirements. Okay, so let's begin with our lecture today. So as we have already described my name, who am I, what subject I'm going to take. So let's start with our introductory lecture. This is the first lecture, as I have already told, and today I am going to give a brief overview or description about the OSI and TCP/IP model. In the next lecture also I am going to continue the discussion, probably because it will take a little bit of time, and I will add up few more examples to make you students to understand the basic functionality, the requirements, the need, advantage and disadvantage of OSI and TCP/IP model, which are basically used to conduct the mobile communication. Okay, so let's begin with our lecture. Okay, so as an introductory class, it is very much expected that I am going to give you the brief overview of OSI reference model and the TCP/IP conceptual layers. Okay, so let's begin with it. As we can see from the shared screen here, that we have 7 layers. In case of OSI, we have 7 layers. First one is physical, second one is data link network, transport, so on and so forth. And if we have a brief comparison with OSI reference model and TCP IP conceptual layers, that there is a small difference between the application part, where in case of OSI we have 3 different categories, but in case of TCP IP conceptual layers we only have one segment. In case of TCP IP we only have one segment, which has been expanded into 3 different layers in case of OSI reference model. Okay, so the first point, the first part that I'm going to discuss here is the physical layer. Okay, so it is the physical layer, right? This is the physical layer. Now what the physical layer is really do is, it basically have a basic physical connectivity. Basically this layer basically used to create the basic connectivity between two specific mobile entity. Now entity means it could be a server, it could be a data center, it could be two different computers. So to have the basic connectivity based upon which all the communication data will be transferred from one entity to the another entity, depending upon the physical. Now I will give a very simple and funny example based upon which or through which you students will be able to understand the basic functionalities of mobile communication, where this specific reference models, which are named as physical, data link, network, transport, and I will denote or take a reference of this specific 3 segment as one segment. I will give a detailed discussion about this 3 part later. Okay, so let's begin. As we are discussing this part, this physical part is nothing but the communication layer, where the data basically communicated from one entity to the another entity. Okay, so optical communication. Okay, I will use a shorthand to lesser our time. Okay, consumption of time. So optical communication, where we use the optical fiber. Okay, different kind of technologies. Today we use different kind of technology. We use spread spectrum technology, where the 2G, 3G will be introduced. Okay, one second. Yes. 2G, 3G will be introduced. Okay, so depending upon that, we use the physical layer as the basic connectivity, as the layer which are basically used as the basic connectivity between two specific computer entity or mobile entity. Okay, so the next layer we are going to discuss is the data link layer. Okay, now this physical layer is basically known as collision domain. Okay, I'll write that. It's called collision domain. It's called collision domain. Okay, the first part. Okay, why? Now suppose I will give a brief example of a classroom. Okay, suppose this is a classroom where we have few students. Suppose we have 9 students here. Okay, now suppose these 9 students are basically act as the entity, as a mobile entity. Okay, now suppose if I have to say something here. Now this entity, suppose this entity is trying to convey something to this entity. Now it will create a signal. Now that signal will be broadcasted. It means it will be conveyed to all the remaining 8 entities. Although this entity is trying to convey this signal to specifically this entity, but it will be broadcasted domain. It will be broadcasting. So every entity will get this signal. So this is the advantage and disadvantage of physical. Okay, so now suppose, so it, what will happen now, Suppose this entity is trying to convey a signal to this entity, and this entity is trying to convey a signal to this entity, but this signal, as it is broadcasted, it will make a collision with this signal. So this is a disadvantage. To overcome this disadvantage, we introduce the data link layer. In this data, and another thing, we will discuss about the devices in the next lecture, about all the layers. Okay, so first we will discuss the basic function. Now, to overcome this disadvantage of physical layer, we introduce a data link layer. In this layer, what will happen? We will have the same kind of classroom, and we have basic 9 entities. I am not going to draw it. Now, in this middle of this, there will be a device. There will be a specific device, and it probably it will known as a switch or a hub. Okay, basically, hub is used for physical layer. We use switch is a good example. I will go with switch. The switch as a device which basically control the broadcasting signal and ensure that the specific signal which has been destined to go to this entity will go to this entity. So the switch as a device will control the signal transmission or the communication of the signal which was basically in physical layer has been broadcasted. Okay, but in case of data link layer, the collision will be reduced by introducing a specific device which has been known as switch, which is going to conduct a brief navigation and help this signal to go to its destined address. Okay, now the third one is known as the network level. Now, how can we understand the network level? Now, we'll take another example in the next slide. Okay, and these are the protocols. I am going to give a brief description about the protocol. Okay, so as we are trying to, yes, okay. So now, suppose we are going to understand what is network layer is. Okay, so in case of network layer, suppose this classroom which have 9 entities. And suppose now we take another classroom which also have 9 more entities, identical network, it to have a clear good assumption. Now suppose this classroom is a network, it is known as network 1, and this classroom is known as network 2. Okay, now to convey the message from this N1 network to this N2 network, we will introduce this network to navigate and to have a proper and good quality communication. We are going to use the network layer, and in case of network layer, we use a device which is known as router. Okay, we are going to discuss about the devices also, don't worry. So as you are saying, so this is the device which is going to navigate from one network to another network to get us basic understanding that this network has few basic properties, and this N2 is also has few basic properties which are probably different or could be equal or same, right? So depending upon that, using or introducing a specific device which is known as router, we are going to have a communication between this network and this network. Okay, so this is the basic function of network. And in case of, if you are talking about transport layer, what is the basic function of a transport layer? Is nothing but traffic control or controlling traffic congestion. Okay, it's also known as a process to process layer. Okay, so this is the basic, and we are going to talk about the application layer. Okay, this is also okay. We're going to talk about the application layer. Okay, in the next lecture. Okay, thank you. So we're going to end our lecture today here.